Okay, so I've just set up for to start a new painting this morning, and I thought I'd just first of all just kind of talk about the decisions I've made in starting something here. First of all, I'm working with a canvas that I've had for quite a while. I just dug through a pile. It's already been gessoed, and I just love the texture that's on it. I don't know if you can see that, but it's got this under texture that I think will be really pretty coming through this painting. So, and I also decided I wanted to work on a canvas. I kind of contemplated that and possibly working with this one. Again, it's just an older kind of a just really quick painting that I had done. And I love painting over previous paintings. This is kind of like an underpainting for me, and this attracted me, and so that has been my inspiration, my color this morning that I want to start with. And I'm going to be working on this canvas and my color palette. I have been working on using some of these old little paintings that I had as travel paints, and so I'm using these up and kind of starting to add some other colors for my small paintings anyway. So this is my color palette. Cadmium yellow is, I use it a lot in mixing with all my colors. And I have other yellows too, but I seem to always favor this. You can see the inside of it. It's almost gone, plus I dip into it a lot with other colors. Then over here, I think I've got a pyrrole red, and then a magenta pink, which I absolutely love mixing with my cadmium yellow, and I get some oranges that way. I very rarely use a straight orange out of the jar. There's just something about it. I like to mix it. This is Indian yellow, and this is I can't pronounce it. It's dioxine violet, but I love mixing this a dab with other colors, and it makes a beautiful coffee color too with yellow. And then I've got phthalo blue down here, which is another color that if I had to just choose one blue, it would be it, because it just feels like it mixes all kinds of really beautiful blues out of that one color. And then I've got a Payne's gray. I've got white gesso up here, and that's what I will begin with. And then I like to use titanium white as I progress on through my painting, and a lot of times with the very last layer, it kind of like pops a little bit more. So I'm not sure if I'll get to that point where I actually have a completed painting, but today basically I just wanted to show you my start, and we'll see how far I go on it. But these are my brushes that I've decided on. This is one of my favorite ones when I'm working with a small painting, and it's got an angled edge to it. And this is a brand new brush, believe it or not. I've only used it a couple times, and it's already, edges are already starting to curl. I do a lot of scrubbing when I'm painting. This is another one here, you can see it's around, another favorite, but I just scrub a lot, so I end up with old brushes very quickly. So this is a nice one to start with. I cover a lot of area with that, and then I will begin to get smaller, and a lot of times I may just use the same brush too as I go through. So I've got my brushes lined out here, my paints. I've got water over here, and I use a lot of paper towels as I'm working. So, you know, where am I gonna start with this thing? It's always kind of a it's kind of like already this underpainting here, and kind of just following some of that. So just playing around a lot, starting off. So, I always like to show my process, because I feel like a lot of what I do is really ugly for a long time, and I just keep working through it until I begin to find things that start beginning kind of popping out as, wow, that's really cool, right? That's really pretty. And then that will begin to lead me to some other steps as I go along. But a lot of times I'm not very pretty starting off. Okay, so where do I want to start as far as color? Well, I said I really was kind of intrigued with that. Kind of almost on orangey today. And so here we go. That's kind of mixing in with that white, which I'm not really being really crazy about right now. I'm talking about, I love that right there, the intensity right there, but anyway, we're just gonna go with it and see. Here we go. Basically, all I want to do is cover a canvas with paint. And it will begin to kind of spur on some ideas. So as I'm starting here, I don't have any ideas other than what I just told you. I kind of like that orange that I saw this morning. So I'm just kind of going with that. There's a lot of mixing that takes place off the side here that, I really don't know what I'm doing. I experiment a lot. Lots of experimenting goes on. And you know, this part is really enjoyable too, because I mean, I get to see all this stuff that happens. Like I'm really loving the contrast between what's going on here. Doubt that it will stay. I'll be covering it up later, but for now it's a part of this painting that I am enjoying. So I'm gonna go ahead and use a little of that purple too, and just get some darks in here. I will use the end of my brush a lot in my painting. Okay, well, I'm feeling like kind of going with that. Purple and yellow here. That coffee I was talking about. So. I just cleaned my table off last night. I put on a fresh sheet of plastic. The last video I did was kind of like a little experiment too, and this is too. But you could hardly see the painting because there were so many colors that were mixed up all the way around. So this might make it a little bit easier, but it won't stay that way. Now, I really don't like that at all. I don't really like what's happened there, but I also know that it's okay, because in the end, it could end up being something that really works out well. All right, so composition-wise, I'm already kind of seeing something working. Like this whole area right in here could be an area that I really work, and I could leave this very neutral down here, and that would help to kind of to be a resting place for the eye. I tend to get a lot of stuff going on, so. Alright, I'm really liking it. I'm liking some things that are happening here. Just to kind of spur on some more ideas. I know this won't get covered up, but I'm just going to go with kind of over the more in the detail mode, which is not something I really do until the end, but why not? Why not do some right now? Using my skinny brush. Something here. It may end up being too wet to work for very long, but we're going to try it anyway. I'm wanting to just take out some stuff and see what happens. I know. Okay. Ooh, I like that. That's cool. I like the way it just softens this up right away. Yeah, and I like that too. Yes. Crazy about that color again, like I said, but I'm just trying to get a first layer in that kind of like spurs me on with some ideas, some stuff that I like. It's the color that's bothering me right now, but again, remember I said that could be something that works out in the end, so let's keep that in mind, right? I feel like I've kind of lost my mind a little bit here talking while I'm painting. I don't ordinarily talk, but I'm kind of trying to give you a little bit of a piece of my mind as I'm working. I'm trying to get to, now that's a kind of like an apple green. I was trying to get more to a seafoam green, but I'm not. So I'm just going to go ahead and use it because we're not anywhere near where. And I like that better than I did that other green that was in there. So this painting has a ways to go. So I'm going to go ahead for now. Let's see if I can't get me a neutral, kind of neutral gray. It's a neutral, but it's kind of got a bluish tint to it. Yeah, and I'm wanting more of a gray, so how can I get there? Let's add a little bit of yellow to that. Now it's kind of going on the pinkish side. Yeah, so there's a lot of, there we go. There's a lot of mixing, playing, experimenting with colors. Some of it will actually start mixing too while I'm on the canvas. So there we go, we'll do that. Stuff I'm liking, but I don't know where to go next, so part of it is it's still wet too, so let's see what I can do here next. Oh, I'm liking this. I'm going to use this little scrub brush a little bit here. I'm seeing an orange kind of rusty on the orange side that I'm really loving a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and find some places for it. As I go along, I'm seeing stuff I want to keep, and that's what I'm doing right there. Is just kind of Not sure how all of this is going to work out, but it would be interesting figuring out how to get it to work out. I'm just really still playing and seeing things that I like, seeing things that I don't like. But just kind of I feel like I'm beginning to want to get much lighter with many of these colors, so I'm going to start adding some whites. It's kind of basically that same color right there. I'm really wanting to some mark making. I really like those a lot. Some little things that I hope to keep. Okay. I get into that point where I'm thinking I may need to let go for a while, but I'm still seeing some stuff here I want to. So I think I want to have some variety. So I've got some kind of straight lines, some bars, and these little dots, and these little lines. This is still gonna be. I intend to go over this with a really light neutral. Some of this you'll still be able to see coming through. So I'm starting to think ahead as to what kind of things I want to have happening. I'm not too sure about there. That might kind of end up like this is over here. So I'm now at this point I'm really starting to think about the direction of this painting, where it's going to go. Ooh, I really like that really light pink. Nice. So, what do I want to do with it? Yeah, see? I'm still really wet, though. other stuff here, so it's kind of hard to look it in right now, but I've got it, so I'm going to use it. I really like that. Really soft, soft pink. There it is. I know where the direction I'd like to go with this is get softer. Get softer as I go along. This is gonna be lighter down here. It's gonna be lighter. This, I'm not really that crazy about it right now. I've been saying that for a while. I haven't been with that area. So we'll see. A lot of times some of those areas turn out to be really beautiful when I'm ready to just kind of like take a risk and be willing to mess some things up. So I feel like I could probably cut in there with something, and maybe I'll start heading in a direction I kind of like. Let's just try this. Let's try some of this. So basically, you know, this is my process. I just kind of keep looking at things, discovering new things, things that I really like, things that I don't like. Sometimes I end up having to cover up things that I do like, but I'll just keep at it. Till it becomes beautiful. That's what I'm after. It's just something that's really beautiful to look at. I'm messing around with those textures a little bit. And it takes time. Sometimes they happen very quickly, but most of the time, my paintings anyway, take a little bit of time. From where I'm at right now with this, I'm probably feeling like I'm about halfway through. If I leave it for a while and come back, I'll really begin to see some new things, some things that I really like in it. And when I've been working on something for quite a while, it's kind of like you lose your perspective. And I just really love that color right there. I don't know what I would call that. Kind of a... it's really pretty. So, what else can I do with that is what I start saying. And it almost looks like there's some popping through here, so why not emphasize that a little bit more? Let's see where I can go with it. Again, this green over here is just like... bothers me. Let me see if I can't get a little bit more of that color, and I'm gonna go ahead and add some regular tanning to it. There we go. Yeah. This is not something that I usually do, by the way. But, I mean, I've done it a time or two, but really my brush is like something I've just discovered. And it was working, so I'm continuing with it. I'm wanting that to be darker. Let's go. And part of it is mixing with the green underneath it, so. Anyway. I still like that. Alright, so. I'm looking at this upside down right now as I'm working. I do turn my paintings many times as I work. Kind of helps get a new perspective when you've been looking at it for a while. It's kind of like going away from it and then coming back, looking at it. Helps to see new things. Okay. So I like what's going on, and it's hard for me because I've been working on this for a little while. I'm just actually just feeling that I'm liking it. I can't really say for sure that I like it until I get away from it for a while. I'm going to go ahead and see if I can mix a little bit of a neutral here. Is that my black? Yeah. More of a blue. That's a purple. It's too much. Yikes. Too much. Too much. Too much. Too much. Oh my god, let's see if I can't find a regular. I just want black. There we go. So a bit black. Just a little bit. Okay. I do want to have some color in my neutral too, so I'm kind of liking that. Maybe a little bit lighter. And it might change again down the line, but for now. I'm kind of seeing where I like to have some more circles down here. So yeah, I'm basically starting to work on composition now. I'm just gonna go ahead and knock into this area a little bit. And see what happens. I got a feeling this is gonna be a problem area, but that's okay. So, there is a lot of stuff happening in this painting, so I'm going to go ahead and set it aside, and because I still have a lot of paint left over here, and if I just walk away from it, it's going to dry. I'm going to go ahead and use some of it on this painting, and maybe I can get something else going here. Who knows? I've actually been doing two starts here. Gosh, I've been mixing a lot of green that I just don't like today. What's the deal? What is the deal? Okay. It's green day today, I guess. But that's okay, because I'm gonna go ahead and get some of this out real quick, a little bit of it anyway. Ooh, that's a pretty color. Basically just easing up paint right now, so yeah, I'm not really worried if it's not working out, but you can kind of see the start of another painting happening. What else have I got on here I can use up? So actually that's about it. So the start of another painting.